Hey guys, welcome to What Is It Wednesday? We're talking about programming for generalization. So there's seven ways to program for generalization. I'm only going to talk about one of them today, but what's important to know is that programming for generalization is something that starts from the very beginning. You don't want to teach in such a way that the client is not able to generate other connections and, you know, practice the skills that they acquire in the learning environment beyond that learning environment, beyond the learning materials, beyond the person with whom the learning happens. So one of the steps is what's being described in this week's question, which is called indiscriminable contingencies. And what that means is that from the beginning, once a skill starts to become acquired or met, right? We want to make sure that the contingencies that are available for that skill are both intermittent and or delayed, so that whatever happens in other environments does not prevent the occurrence of the behavior. And in fact, the behavior can be omitted no matter what contingencies are in place. So the more variety, the more variability in the contingencies that you set out in the original learning environment, the more likely the client will generalize and maintain that skill to other environments where the contingencies might be different. There might be longer time between reinforcement. There might be delays in the reinforcement. Whatever distinctions or differences in the contingencies are, the client will be already used to these indiscriminable, I don't know when reinforcement is coming, contingencies, and therefore the behavior will generalize to whatever contingencies exist in whatever environments their skills generalize to. I hope that helps, guys, and I'll see you next time.